All right, sorry, I'm having issues here. Okay, sorry about that, folks. The selects just scored. I have no idea if you could see it properly or not. Probably not, because I was trying to fix other things. It's now 3-1. Selects scored. I know nothing. So we'll wait for the announce. I don't even know who was on the ice to even have a guess as to who might have scored. But it is now 3-1 for the Northern Subway Selects over the Edsa West Reds. And as soon as we get the announcement of the goal, we'll pass that along, certainly, obviously. And apologies for the errors with the first bit of this period. There's a shot, and the puck played nearly into the back of the net, but knocked away there by Terrio with a big play to save a goal. Now Stiles trying to clear the zone. So it was Aaron McNeil scoring from Jalen Langell and Bree McPherson. at 5:32, and for Langell, McNeil, that's her third goal, fifth point of the season. So again, Aaron McNeil, third goal, fifth point, assisted by Jalen Langell and Bree McPherson at 5:32, making it 3-1. Bird with the puck, plays it ahead to Marmon. Marmon has it knocked away from her. Now battle towards the corner. LeBlanc coming over to help out as Harvey. Marmon will end up with the puck. She'll try and skate it away from the wall. Has it knocked off her stick. Harvey picks up. She'll take it back towards the corner. Now throws it towards the front of the net. It gets deflected back to Ferguson. Ferguson shot. That goes wide. Marmon back on it. Back to the line. Shot taken there by McPhee. That gets blocked. And now the Selects, Bree McPherson looking to clear the zone. She can't. Puck comes to LeBlanc. Her pass intercepted by Ferguson. Ferguson steps in, gets a shot, and Arsenault makes the save and hangs on with 7:56 gone here in the second period, and the Selects now leading it 3-1. Mairead McPherson in the corner battling there with Isabel Michaud. Now the puck comes up to McNeil. Mairead McPherson again gives to McNeil. McNeil able to get it out to center down the ice, but hustling back to get on the puck is Boudreau. She'll play it to Theriault. Theriault now trying to skate through a couple of checkers. Gets the puck in deep around the far side. Michaud trying to center it. That was cleared away. And now Greencorn gets it to the line, held in by Scott. Played down, knocked down by McPherson, and she'll fire it down the ice. That's going to be an icing call with just under 8 minutes gone here in the second period. Puck comes into the near side corner. Now played back around to the far side. Langell trying to get there just ahead of Stiles, the two number 12s, although Stiles, as we mentioned in the first period, normally wears number 3, but had a bit of a mishap with her jersey. Somehow it didn't end up making the trip. Clavette gets the puck deep into the Select zone, gets a shot away from a sharp angle, and the save made by Arsenault. And she'll hang on for a face-off with just under 8.5 gone here in the second. Lawrence to take the draw against Stewart. Neither player wins it cleanly. Finally, Lawrence able to kick it to Clavette. Clavette sends it around the boards. Geno is the first one on it behind the net. Now trying to get away from the forecheck of Tower. Gets the puck over to Langell. She'll play it ahead for Stewart. Stewart tries to make a pass. That gets knocked down. Now Geno will reverse it over towards the near side for Bree McPherson. And McPherson able to skate through the check of Lawrence and out to center. McPherson stops. Tries to get the puck to Stewart. That pass a little beyond her reach. Tower couldn't do anything with it, though, and now it's played back out. Picked up by Geno just ahead of Clavette. Geno makes the pass ahead to Smith. Smith able to find Frazier. Frazier takes it to the corner. Now starts to work her way back up. Back down into the corner again. Sarah Frazier, who normally plays defense but has been required to spend a lot of time as a forward so far this season due to various injuries and whatnot. A very versatile, very valuable player for these Selects in that she can fill so many different roles. Here's Frazier with the puck again, trying to get away from Bird. or from McKay, excuse me. Now here's Smith, her pass back to Mairead McPherson, and that ends up going through her all the way down to Arsenault. Arsenault settles it for LeBlanc. LeBlanc up the wall, back to Frazier again. She'll dump it back into the red zone as the Selects make a wholesale five-person unit change. On the puck now done. She plays it over to Geno. Geno misplays it slightly, and that allows Marmon to get the puck deep into the Select end and back to pick up Dunn. She'll reverse it to Marks. Marks can't quite reach that puck. Michaud couldn't do anything with it. Now Marks gets it back. She'll play it over to the far side for Greencorn. Greencorn chips it ahead. Knocked down by McPhee. McPhee plays it around towards the near side. And the puck goes up and into the netting here at Hector Arena, so we'll get a stoppage with 9:14 left to go here in the second period. Got to give a big shout out to all of the staff here at Hector Arena for the great job that they did getting this piece of plexiglass put in here at my broadcast position. All the way around, as with many of these small barns all across North America, they got the netting all the way around. But what we did here, and they did it, kind of makes me feel, you know, important. They did it specifically for me and for these broadcasts. As here comes in McNeil with a shot, and Michaud makes the save and hangs on. But they put in this piece of plexiglass. You can see how there's the netting coming all the way across, and then here we got plexiglass to shoot through. So I got to give a huge shout out to Ron and the entire Hector Arena staff for all of that great work that they did putting this in. It's a beautiful, beautiful position they've got me at here. It's still not like, I mean, I'm not, that there are definitely logistical challenges with doing a broadcast from one of these smaller barns. Don't really have a table set, a table to set up for, or a spot to set up a table to put all my gear on and whatnot. So I've got it literally sitting on the stands as I'm standing here in sort of the top of a stairway. But we're doing what we can with what we got, and it's all things considered, a pretty good setup. There's a shot from the point by LeBlanc, partially blocked by Clavette. Now the puck gets to the far side for Bree McPherson. She gets it down to Thompson. Thompson with the shot, and Christy Michaud with her 22nd save of the afternoon, heading towards evening here in beautiful Pictou County. One thing we forgot to do at the beginning of the broadcast, and I sincerely apologize for this, partly because I was in a little bit of a chaos mode at the beginning. We forgot to do, as we're going to get a penalty against the Selects coming up here in a moment, as soon as they touch the puck. Tripping is the indication.
You violated the law. Pay the court a fine or serve your sentence.
And it looks like it's going to be Megan Smith who comes off for the tripping call at 12:14 of the second period. So the Edsa West Reds, who are 1-for-1 so far on the power play, get their second opportunity of the afternoon slash evening. And getting back to what we hadn't done prior to the at the start of the broadcast is acknowledge that Hector Arena, the town of Pictou, and in fact all of Pictou County, sit within the ancestral and unceded territory of Mi'kma'ki. And so I do apologize to the Mi'kmaq people for not getting that land acknowledgement in at the beginning of the broadcast as I normally do. I was a little distracted by some technical issues that I was having, but we get that in there now, and it is certainly an important acknowledgement to make. as the Selects continue on the penalty kill here. 1:15 left to go in the penalty. Sarah Stewart forechecking, but getting onto the puck was Ferguson. She gets it ahead to Bird. Bird can't get a shot away, though, as Geno was there. Now Clavette will pick up the puck. Down behind the net. Clavette into the near corner, plays it back to the line to Ferguson. Ferguson faked a shot and then went to make a pass down low, but that was intercepted by Langell. And now Langell coming up with McNeil. Langell and McNeil, 2-on-0. Langell to McNeil. And McNeil tried to make a return pass to Langell and fanned on it. And that allowed Michaud to poke that puck away. A 2-on-0 shorthanded. And the Selects don't even really get a shot away. We'll have to wait and see if that becomes a significant moment in this game. Selects leading by 2 right now. They could have gone up by 3. But not getting a shot away there. Now here's Thompson down low. She'll play it into the far corner, and Isabel Michaud will pick up there. She has it knocked off her stick by Stewart. Now Stewart gives to Thompson. Here comes Thompson coming in. And a big save made by Michaud, as Michaud's had to come up huge a couple of times on this penalty that has now completed. Here's Marmon. And we're going to get a penalty against the Selects again, it looks like. Our officials are talking it over. So it's going to be Brooke Thompson, a 4-minute double minor for head contact. So this a certainly a big moment in this game, as the Reds with a 4-minute power play and a chance to pull within one and possibly tie it up if they can score in both halves of this penalty. Although in the last penalty that the Selects just killed off a moment ago, they had the two most dangerous chances in the whole 2-minute period. There's Bird. She can't get a shot off. Harvey can't either. And the Selects, Smith kicks the puck as far as the line. Ferguson holds it in. But now it's cleared out down the ice by Frazier. 45 seconds gone in the double minor to Brooke Thompson. Here's Lawrence with the puck. She'll play it ahead to Marmon. Marmon in across the line, gives to Isabel Michaud. She drops off to Boudreau. Boudreau across, intended for Scott. That pass a little bit off target. Puck comes off the wall and out. And now here's Langell coming in. She's got Stewart trailing. Langell can't get a shot away, loses the puck, but Stewart picks it up, brings it over towards the near wall. Boudreau will come away from the wall with it after the battle. Plays it ahead, knocked down there by Dunn. Dunn will send it back down into the red zone. Right on to Michaud, who settles it down for Thériault. 2.5 left to go in the double minor. Here is Thériault working her way up the ice, in across the line, drops it back to Harvey. Harvey takes it towards the wall. Now she'll come back up the wall, back to Clavette. Clavette fans on her shot attempt, and that'll allow Langell to get the puck and roll it down the ice. Michaud settles it for Harvey. The first half of the double minor about to expire. Pass ahead to Thériault. Thériault gets taken towards the wall by Bree McPherson. Now the puck rolls down into the corner. And it is, I believe, Lily LeBlanc in there battling with 3 Reds players. Finally, the puck comes free to Lawrence. LeBlanc gets back on it, fires it around the wall. Thériault holds it in at the line. Now in behind the net. Puck goes to the far corner. LeBlanc gets there just ahead of Lawrence. Puck squirts free. Now it comes back to LeBlanc. Her clearing attempt goes off of the foot of Clavette. Now Isabel Michaud trying to get it to Lawrence, but that pass doesn't connect, and it's fired down the ice. 1:18 left to go in the double minor. Big kill here for the Selects so far to keep it a 2-goal game with under 3 minutes left to go in the second period. Here comes Thériault. Gets around Frazier. In across the line. Terrio. Drop pass for Michaud. Michaud couldn't get the puck settled for a shot. Lawrence couldn't find it. Now it comes to the line. Terrio holds it in. She fires a shot. A save made. Rebound. Picked up by Lawrence. Lawrence got it to Clavette. Clavette with a backhander, but Arsenault able to watch that one in and make the save and cover up for a faceoff. And now we're going to get a roughing penalty against one of the selects. It's looks like it's going to be Aaron McNeil going off for roughing. So for 45 seconds, the selects will be down 5-on-3. So a 5-on-3 here as the selects have taken 8 minutes in penalties in the last, what will have been in the last 7:45 overall of the period. And with the overlap and whatnot, they've been they were even strength for about 4 seconds in between, or for 6 seconds, excuse me, in between the end of the penalty to Smith and the start of the penalty to Thompson. And then we had the 30-some-odd seconds of overlap and still 7 of that left as the penalty to Thompson's about to expire. We're about to go back to 5-on-4. There's Clavette with a shot. That hits a body in front. Loose puck picked up. And Stewart battling hard, but she's not able to clear the zone as it's taken from her by Bird. 1:05 left to go now in the latest penalty. Here's Clavette with a shot. That's blocked by Arsenault. As we're down to 80 seconds left in the period, and if the selects can hold on to this two-goal lead, it'll be a huge, huge sequence of kills here. Here's Bree McPherson with the puck now. She'll play it up the near wall. Picked up by Geno, and she will get it down the length of the ice. 35 seconds left to go in the penalty into the final minute of the second period. A big sequence of kills so far for the selects. Now are we going to see another penalty as Ferguson got tripped up? No, they're not going to call that one as Boudreau takes the puck down into the select zone. Boudreau behind the net. Goes out all the way into the far corner. Plays it back to the line for Isabelle Michaud. Her shot gets deflected, goes wide, comes off the end boards to Mairead McPherson. She gets it as far as the line, not out. 8 seconds left in the penalty. There's a shot. It goes wide. Pinching in is Terrio. The penalty to McNeil has expired, and the selects have killed everything off. They now have 20 more seconds of period left before they can get a breather. Here's Megan Smith with the puck. Smith taking her time, gives it to Clark. Clark plays it back as the selects are just trying to play keep away for these last few seconds. They're going to end up icing the puck. And with about 2.8 seconds left in the period, there will be a faceoff in the red zone, but the selects will be able to get some fresh legs for this last block of 2.8 seconds to try and keep this a 2-1 or a 3-1 game. We said we were going to try and get you some updates on the out-of-town scoreboard. I'm not really able to do that quite as well as I would like to with the setup that I've got here, so we'll see if we can get you something for the start of the third period. But in the meantime, we've finished up the second period here. Shots on goal, 12-8 in favor of the selects in period number two. The two-period total favors the selects 28-18. Just one goal in that period. It was Aaron McNeil's third goal of the season to extend the lead. It's now Northern Subway Selects 3, Edsa West Reds 1. We're going to take a break, come back, get you ready for the third period in just a few minutes. You are watching Maritime Major Female Hockey League action here on Petr Pictou Sports through 360 Live.
Hockey is a part of us, a part of our community, and a part of our heritage. We are in unprecedented times, but in these times we respond with love, resilience, kindness, and strength. From the front lines to behind the scenes, our essential workers have stood up and stood up to help keep our community strong. To all you heroes, thank you. For those who stayed the Blazes home and did everything they could to help their neighbor during these difficult times, thank you. Today we gather as a community, as a province united, to welcome back a pastime that unites us more than anything could. From the frozen ponds in Yarmouth and North Sydney to the ice surfaces in Amherst, Antigonish, Colchester, Halifax, Kentville, and Pictou County, hockey is back.
Something better than a soft
Welcome back as we get ready for the start of the third period here. Quick look at the out-of-town scoreboard. The other two games today, the Halifax Western Capitals lead the Edson East Moncton Subaru Rockets by a score of 4-0. That game is now a final. So the Caps with a 4-0 victory over the Rockets there. One other game getting started in about 10 minutes. The Cape Breton Lynx are down at the RBC Centre in Dartmouth to visit the Bussey Auto Brokers Penguins. Tomorrow, the same three matchups in the same three locations. The game here, 9:30 tomorrow morning. The Rockets at Capitals, 10:15 tomorrow morning. And the Lynx at the Penguins tomorrow at noon. So one game already final here in the Maritime Major Female Hockey League today. As mentioned, the Halifax Western Capitals with the victory over the other New Brunswick team, the EDSA East Rockets, the EDSA East Moncton Subaru Rockets. So the EDSA West TNT Reds looking to do what their provincial counterparts were not able to do earlier today, and that is come into Nova Scotia and get a victory. In order to do that, they're going to need at least three goals to get a win against the Northern Subway Selects here in the third period, as the Selects carry a two-goal lead into this third. And coming in right away, there's Thompson and Stewart, and a couple of nice saves made there by Michaud to keep that puck out, as Stewart and Thompson in on a dangerous rush in right off the get-go. Just 16 seconds gone here in the third period. As I just mentioned, the game tomorrow morning at 9:30. Same location as today's game. Go to 360live.com and click for the link for today's game, or for tomorrow's game tomorrow morning. Don't click it now, obviously. But we'll have all the action from here at the Hector Arena bright and early tomorrow morning. And part of the reason for the 9:30 start, obviously, is to give the Reds plenty of time to get back home after the game tomorrow. Be home in time to get to school on Monday, although with the forecast that I'm hearing for Monday, speaking as a teacher, I have to say, you know, hopefully the weather holds off and we can all go to school on Monday. But I'm not going to lie. There are times when teachers hope for the snow day just as much as the kids do. Here comes a chance for Frazier, but coming out to get the puck, and then Frazier ends up running into Michaud. And it looked like Frazier caught her knee there. We're going to see Frazier come back to the bench. She's looks to be in a little bit of discomfort there, although she's kind of might have been chuckling a little bit about it too. Puck played back to the line to Geno. She gets it over to Bree McPherson. McPherson plays it down the far side wall, goes in behind the net. Greencorn picks up there, comes to the near side with it, comes up the wall again to Geno. You know, has it roll away from her, and it'll be picked up by Clavette. Clavette's got Tower with her. Clavette, though, held up by Bree McPherson. And McPherson able to get the puck around. And the Selects able to come out. Here comes McNeil. Aaron McNeil with the shot, looking to go short side. And didn't miss by much on that one. Now played back to the line, Mairead McPherson. And she also having trouble keeping the puck under control. And it's back into the zone. Lawrence picks up there. Her pass gets deflected to the line and not out. Clark now able to pick it up and take it down towards the corner, working against McPhee. Clark getting tied up by McPhee and Lawrence. As we're down 2.5 minutes gone here in this third period. There's Fraser trying to get a shot away, but it goes off a skate into the corner. Smith sends it to Clark behind the net. Smith comes back to help out, but McPhee is there. McPhee able to get the puck up for Marmon, but she was tied up there by LeBlanc. Down towards the corner, picked up by Clark. She'll take it behind the net. Clark still with it, now plays it back to the line for Mairead McPherson. She sends it around the boards. Fraser will get to it in the far corner just ahead of Marmon, but then that's broken up by Waters. She plays it up the wall, held in by LeBlanc. Battle along the wall. Puck comes to Lawrence. She'll get it ahead to Scott. Here comes Scott, working her way ahead. Scott with the shot. And the save made by Arsenault, and she lets the puck go to keep the clock running here. 16.5 left to go in the third period. Isabel Michaud plays it over to Harvey. Harvey has it knocked off her stick, picked up by Fraser. Fraser will carry all by herself, waiting for line mates to change. Gets the shot away, and the save made by Michaud, and she'll hold on for a faceoff. 3:47 gone here in the third period. Thompson and Harvey taking the draw. Stewart picks up the puck. Stewart coming towards the net, but couldn't quite get that one tucked in for a decent shot there. And the puck cleared down the ice. That's going to be an icing call. And we approach 4 minutes gone here in the third period. Thompson and Harvey to deal with the draw again here. Thompson wins this one cleanly back to Dunn. Dunn sends it down off the end boards. Thompson picks up there. Plays it back to Geno. Geno with the shot. Knocked down by Harvey, but it's picked up by Langell. She gives to Thompson. Thompson plays it over to Dunn at the far wall. Dunn down to Stewart. Stewart trying to get herself free into a shooting position. She falls. Stiles clears the puck to the area behind the net, but Thompson picks that up. She'll get it to Stewart. Stewart trying to cut towards the middle of the ice, has the puck roll away from her. Stiles gets it and gives to Terrio. Terrio up the wall. Dunn will hold that puck in and get it to Thompson. Thompson has it knocked away from her by Harvey. Harvey uses the glass and gets the puck out to center. Race for the puck. Isabel Michaud and Dunn get there right around the same time. But the Selects now on it as they look to clear the zone. Geno will play it back to Dunn. She has it go off her skate right to Marmon. Marmon down into the corner. She has it knocked away from her by Thompson. Now in behind the net. Into the corner, picked up by Boudreau. Boudreau plays it back to Terrio. Back to Boudreau again. Her pass down low, broken up by Dunn. Dunn fires it down the ice. And will that get on target onto the net? Yes, it will, so no icing. As Michaud had to play it, she settled it for Terrio. Here comes Terrio. Stepping up was LeBlanc. And now bringing it in across the line, Marks. Leaves it there for LeBlanc, but it's picked up instead by Boudreau. Boudreau makes a nice move. Boudreau with a backhand shot. Save made. Puck cleared away from danger there by Bree McPherson. She gets it ahead to Greencorn. Here comes Kenzie Greencorn working around McPhee. Greencorn takes it behind the net. Still with the puck. Now plays it back to the line. Fanning on a shot is LeBlanc. And that allows Scott to get it out to center. Picking up as she comes back is Aaron McNeil. McNeil uses the boards, gets it ahead, intended for Greencorn. That's broken up there by Ferguson. And now it's dumped the rest of the way in, and McPhee goes back to get it, nearing 6.5 gone in this third period. McPhee, long lead pass, broken up by Smith. Smith bringing it into the red zone, all the way down into the corner, sends it behind the net, out in front as they jam at it, but now it's cleared over towards the corner. In the corner, McPhee. Smith gets the puck. It comes out towards the front of the net. Ferguson was there, but not able to maintain control. Now picking up again is Frazier. She has it knocked off her stick by Tower, but it goes right to McPherson. Her shot blocked by Tower, and Tower able to get it out to center. Ferguson gets tripped up, but gets the puck to Clavette. And now we're going to get a penalty, as Ferguson did get tripped up there. And so we're going to see yet another Reds power play here with 7:10 gone in the third period. Tripping the indication as Mairead McPherson comes to the box with 7:10 gone. The Selects have killed off 4 of 5 penalties so far this afternoon. This is the 6th chance for the Reds. They're looking to go 2 for 6 to pull the game to within 1. Stewart not able to get on the puck, but Bree McPherson does and gets it down the length of the ice. Ferguson now plays it up the wall. Harvey will pick up in stride. Here comes Harvey working down the left wing. Harvey gets slowed up by Geno. Geno able to pick up the puck. Ties it up in the corner. Clavette's in there, as is Harvey. Harvey will come away with the puck. Back to the line for Ferguson. Ferguson comes near side. Bird with the shot. That gets blocked by Bree McPherson. Now Ferguson with a shot. That's steered aside by Arsenault. And it goes up over the glass and out of play for a stoppage with 1:13 left in the penalty. 1:03 left to go. Here in 1:13 left in the penalty, 12:03 left to go here in the third period, with the Selects continuing to lead at 3-1. Goals from Sarah Stewart, Ellie Clark, and Aaron McNeil for the Selects. Ella Lawrence with the lone goal for the Reds back in the first period on the power play. Here's Smith with the puck. In behind her own net, gets knocked down, trying to tie the puck up along the wall. Now Tower comes in, as does Boudreau. It's played up the wall. Terrio will hold it there, give to Isabel Michaud. Down into the corner, gets past Tower, in behind the net, Boudreau. She tries to take it towards the corner. She will. Boudreau now getting tangled up with Smith, and the puck is turned over, and Langell able to get it out to center. Michaud now plays it across for Terrio. Terrio didn't have an angle as Langell was on her. Langell now knocks the puck off of Terrio's stick. She has to race back and get it. Terrio trying to get away from the forecheck of Langell, finally does, and then had to circle back as Langell was cutting off her angle. Now a pass ahead for Boudreau. Boudreau, though, has it knocked off her stick by Stewart. Following up on the play was Scott, but she ends up losing it to Dunn. Thompson now will flip it back out to center as the penalty is about to expire. Terrio going back to get the puck. Stewart right there with her, but Terrio got it up to Boudreau. Boudreau played it up the wall. McNeil then sends it back down into the red zone as we approach 9.5 minutes gone here, third period. Selects with another big kill. Now here's Boudreau with a shot. That goes wide. Comes up the near side wall. Gets picked up by Stewart. Here comes Kenzie Greencorn. Taking it down towards the corner. A little quick touch pass between her and McNeil. Now Greencorn goes down. Waters picks up the puck. She looks to play it up the near side, but that's taken away from her by Marks. Now in behind the net, taking a bump there, was McKay. Greencorn gets the puck to Marks. Marks to... that was McNeil with the shot, and Michaud able to make that save. And now the puck cleared out and down the ice, and just hard enough for an icing. With 10:14 gone here in the third period, we're into the last 10 minutes with the Selects continuing to lead it 3-1. As not sure if the audio picked up on that, but Craig Clark basically asking the referees what needs to happen for a penalty to go the other way, as the Selects have taken the last, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4 penalties in a row, and one of those was a double minor. So the last 10 minutes in penalties have all gone against the Selects. In the corner, now skating it out of the corner, Smith gets it back to the line for Mairead McPherson. Her shot through the traffic ends up hitting one of the bodies in front and deflecting wide. And now it comes out. Clavette will get it down the ice. Clavette down into the near side corner, working against LeBlanc. Now four players in that corner. Under 9 minutes left to go, and I wish I could show you what was in that corner, but like I say, we've got that little bit of a dead spot that we can't quite see. Puck gets to the line, held in nicely by McPhee. Now the Selects are able to get it out, but Terrio quickly plays it up the wall again. Across to the far side, Scott will pick up. She'll play it back to McPhee. Ahead for Scott, who deflects it forward, but it goes right onto the stick of Dunn, who dumps it down into the red zone. Back to get it, Terrio. She'll wrap it around for Scott. Scott ends up letting it go. It's picked up by Thompson. Thompson tries to cut to the middle of the ice. Scott knocks it off her stick. Geno just holding that puck onside. Battle along the far wall. Scott looking to clear. It's held in there by Langell. Down for Stewart. She can't find it in her feet. Scott took a whack at it. Not able to clear. Now Thompson sends it in deep. McPhee out from behind her net. Her pass ahead for Scott. Doesn't quite connect. Dunn tries to get a shot away, but Scott able to get her stick in the shooting lane and deflect that puck wide. Now back out to center again. 7:45 to go here in the third. Lawrence able to get the puck down into the Selects' end. Steered towards the corner by Arsenault for Geno. She plays it ahead. Now Stewart drops it to Langell. Langell trying to get through the check of Harvey. She couldn't, and then Boudreaux gave the puck back to Harvey. Here's Harvey taking it towards the corner. Harvey throws it, but not Terrio not able to gather that puck in. Now Isabelle Michaud plays it down in behind the net. Boudreaux. Boudreaux gets it out in front. There's a chance for Michaud, and that shot gets deflected and goes wide. Now Stiles steps forward. Plays it to Boudreaux. Boudreaux can't get a shot away, and Geno will get the puck down to the corner. Faked going one way, then goes the other, trying to get it up to Langell. Langell can't get past the player covering her. That was Stiles. Now back to the line. Terrio with the shot. That goes off a body and into the end boards. Langell now. She swings wildly at the puck and is able to get it down the ice. That's going to be an icing, but the Selects will be able to make a change here with 6:47 left in the third period. Still 3-1 for the Northern Subway Selects here over the Edsa West TNT Reds. Into the late stages of the third period of this very entertaining hockey game. No big surprise, as these were and still are the top two teams in the league standings. We expected two very good hockey games this weekend, and so far through the first 53 and a half minutes of the first game, we've gotten exactly that, and we expect more of the same tomorrow. Again, 9:30 tomorrow morning. Broadcast will start around 9:20. So tune in on Petr Pictou Sports right here on 360 Live for all of the action. Reds win the draw. Back to the line. McKay plays it off the end boards. Clavette gets to the puck. Ends up putting it onto the back of the net. They whack at it. It comes free. Clavette back on it again. She'll play it back to the line. Shot from the point there taken by Waters. Puck comes to McKay. Her shot. And that gets blocked by McPherson. Bree McPherson, that is. Puck comes to the line again. McKay holds it in. Gets it in deep for Clavette. Clavette takes a bump from LeBlanc. Clavette and LeBlanc in the corner. Clavette and LeBlanc. Now in there is Tower. Tower gets control of the puck. Clavette had lost her stick for a moment. Now she's got it back. couple of players go down and they cover up the puck, so we'll get a stoppage. 5:49 left to go here in the third period. As the clock starts to be a bit of a factor here, working in the favor of the hometown Northern Subway Selects. Certainly not at the point where they can just rely on the clock from here. They still have their work to do. Harvey taking that draw against Smith. Smith able to win it, so Murade McPherson can play the puck around to the far side for Frazier. Frazier not able to clear, though, as Bird and Harvey are both all over her. Now Frazier able to pick up the puck. Still not able to clear. Dunn will try and use the other side as she plays it around for Murade McPherson ahead to Frazier. And between Frazier and Clark, they get it out to center. Now, now Frazier tries the wraparound and gets a backhand shot away as she runs into Harvey. And Michaud makes the save and hangs on. 5:16 left to go here in the third. Harvey and Smith to take this draw. Smith wins it. Dunn can't get to the puck before McPhee pokes it ahead for Michaud. Here comes Michaud. She's got Bird with her. Michaud to Bird. Bird, what an attempt at a move by Bird, but Arsenault able to stick out the stick enough that Bird couldn't quite get the puck tucked in. Now Murade McPherson coming the other way. Cuts towards the net. And Michaud will cover up and hang on for a faceoff. 4:52 left to go. Great chance there for Michaud and Bird. But Bird just couldn't quite put the finishing touches on that little move. Gabby Arsenault with a big poke check. Able to get that stick out there enough to disrupt the chance for Caitlin Bird. Stewart wins the draw back to Geno. Geno gives it to Langell. Jalen Langell for Stewart. Stewart's shot goes off the leg of Stiles and wide. Now in the corner, Thompson. Thompson with the shot and Michaud the save, and she'll hang on again. 4:34 left to go in this third period. 3-1 the scoreline, as it has been since the 5:32 mark of way back in the second period. Two goals by the Selects in the first, including one on the power play. One goal by the Reds in the first, that came on the power play. One goal by the Selects in the second. No scoring so far here in the third with 4:23 left to go. Puck held in at the line inside the Select zone by Stiles. Battle along the near side wall. Puck comes loose. Geno plays it around to the far side. Pass ahead now. Stewart gives to Thompson. Thompson to Langell. Langell coming in, working against Stiles. Langell gives to Thompson. Thompson tried to get it back to Stewart. That doesn't connect. Puck comes all the way back to Geno. Her shot blocked by Marmon. Here comes Marmon the other way. Marmon, she's got Scott with her. Marmon gets through one check, gets a shot away. Arsenault the save. She'll hang on, and we're going to get a penalty. Unsportsmanlike conduct is the indication. And it looks like it's going to be Scott who's going to come over. So the Selects will go to the power play for the third time in this game. And with just 3:45 to go in the third period and a two-goal lead, if you're the Selects right now, I think you would choose either outcome, a power play goal or 2 minutes coming off of the clock. Either outcome would be favorable for you. There's LeBlanc with a shot and a save made by Michaud. Now, Murade McPherson plays it to the area behind the net. Waters gets there. She sends it into the corner. McNeil picks up, gives to McPherson. Back to the near side for LeBlanc. LeBlanc will send it down into the corner. Greencorn picks up there. Greencorn gives to McNeil. Over to McPherson. There's a shot. And the bouncing puck, they score! So the penalty does result in another power play goal for the Selects, and I think it's going to be Aaron McNeil's second of the game. Actually, it's going to be Kenzie Greencorn getting credit for the goal with 3:09 left to go. And as we mentioned, the Selects would be favorable with either outcome. They now have the three-goal lead and 3:09 left to go. And that might be the one that they needed to seal this one off. Kenzie Greencorn's second goal, fourth point of the season. There's a chance for Harvey right on, and the Reds score right back. Don't call this game over yet, as it's back to a two-goal game as we get two goals in the span of just a few seconds. Kenzie Greencorn makes it 4-1, and then pretty much right away, the Reds come right back and make it 4-2. So this one's not over yet. It was LeBlanc. I thought it was McNeil, but it was LeBlanc who got that assist. So it was 14, not 4. My apologies. As and now we get So that goal by Isabel Michaud, assisted by Hannah Harvey and Caitlin Bird at 17:02. The Selects goal coming just 11 seconds before that at 16:51. So the Selects make it a three-goal game at 15:01 with Kenzie Greencorn. And then Isabel Michaud with her fifth goal, ninth point of the season, makes it a two-goal game again, assisted by Harvey and Bird at 17:02. Now we're down to 70 seconds left in the game, but the Selects have the Reds hemmed in their own zone. McPhee will pick up the puck. Plays it ahead and out to center. Here's Mairead McPherson across the red line. She'll dump it right back in. Goes off an official, though. Now Thompson will gather the puck up. Thompson sends it behind the net. 40 seconds left to go. Tower trying to clear the zone. Stewart on the puck. She has it taken from her. It's knocked out to center. Mairead McPherson dumps it right back in again, as the Selects are just basically denying the Reds any opportunity to move too far forward. Now they get the puck as far as the Select blue line, but it'll be played down and out and down the ice. With 10 seconds left to go, it looks like the Selects are going to get the victory and pull 4 points ahead. As Scott comes down the ice, that's going to do it. A 4-2 victory as the Selects outshoot the Reds this afternoon, 40-24 overall. Shots in that third period were 12-6, and the Northern Subway Selects with the big 2 points against the team who came in just a couple points behind them in the standings. It's 4-2, your final here this afternoon from Hector Arena. We'll be back here again tomorrow morning, bright and early at 9:30, for the next meeting between these two teams. Until then, this is Michael Petter saying may your skates always be sharp, may your shots always hit the top shelf. Thanks so much for watching. Enjoy the rest of your Saturday evening.